going on video, so.
So did you listen to the new Adele album?
Did you listen to the new Adele album?
Of course I listened to the new Adele album.
So did I. Are we both feeling the feels?
Of course we're feeling the feels. I cried at three different parts of that album. Oh, like actual tears
like
running
tears
down my
came
face.
Down. Mm-hmm. Were you drinking a bottle of wine?
No.
But or was it a cup of tea?
It was a cup of tea.
Oh.
Thank you very much. Very much. You think I am?
Oh my goodness!
Yeah,
four times,
three times, yeah, yeah. What about you? Did you have any like not tears but emotions, feelings?
So I didn't have tears for this one. I didn't have tears for 30, but I, you know, when you're taken aback and then you get into a place where you just all you keep thinking is reminiscing about, you know, a moment.
Adele's good at that.
Yeah, and yeah. I'm like, and I had to kind of take myself out of it for a second because I was just like, oh my gosh, here I am again. And then you start to think like, did you do everything right in that moment? Could you have done something different?
Oh, wow. So you were like introspective at this point.
I got really introspective.
Okay.
Like really introspective for a few moments in that album.
So like when you're laying in bed and you think about like the one stupid thing you said 20 years ago?
Yes.
That kind of thing?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
So which songs made you tear up? Not to get right into it, but can we get right into it?
Little Love made me cry.
I love your dad because he gave you to me. You're half me and you're half daddy.
I'm holding on.
What about it?
Just, it's so, I guess I'd watched the Oprah interview before I'd listened to it, so I knew that like it was voice notes from when she was in therapy and going through her divorce, and that's like really close to my heart.
Yeah.
Just the whole thing and like the way she dedicated it to her son, and yeah, I mean it was just so
raw.
That's raw. That's the right word for it. What was your favorite song on the album?
Guess.
Yeah. You're gonna put me on the spot.
I'm gonna put you on
the guess
spot.
Wrong. There's only like 12 songs on the album. I Drink Wine.
No. It's actually Hold On.
If you just hold on. Hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. Just
hearing her voice, and is like, you know, she has this vibrato in her voice, and there was a moment where I think it actually cracked a little bit. Mm-hmm. And she was like really grunting that whole, I don't know, I just felt it,
yeah.
You know, and just the beat, the lyrics of it all.
Resonated,
you know,
with
it
you.
Just resonated, right? And it's just like she gives you the emotion,
She
right?
does. She gives you all the elements to like we said, be introspective, right? Like think about things that you've done in your life. I had a top three.
What was your top three?
My top three, in this order, was Oh My God,
yeah,
I Drink Wine, and Love Is a Game.
Love is a game.
I like them all because
it's a game for fools.
Not I.
I did like that one. I did like that's a good song. That's a good song.
It is. I liked those three because like all of her music is so deep, but they were all fun. Those three were like they were nice. Like you could move to them. You know, I wasn't just crying to those ones.
I really
liked Woman Like Me as well. Definitely wasn't in my top three, but like you can tell that she, in my mind, she was hurt.
Mm-hmm.
She realized that she was done dirty, like she didn't deserve it. And then she overcame it and was like, hey, you'll never get something this good again. Yeah. And like, I have so much respect for that.
Yeah.
So.
You know what, I love that, you know, you brought it up earlier about her using the voice notes because I think it added a personal touch.
It did.
And I feel like we all know Adele because her music resonates, but I think like a lot of people when they listen to their music, including myself, it's like you think about your own situations, and then this was kind of like a, you know, unveiling the curtain to her own situation on an even deeper level.
For sure, and I feel like artists are finding ways to make their stuff so much more creative, like Beyonce with the visual albums and now this with the voice notes. Like it just adds a different layer because we're talking like hundreds of years of music that we now have, right? So how are you making that new? And I think that that's what the voice notes is a really good way of doing that.
Yeah, it was so nice. And then I also love the fact that she forced Spotify to not made people have to go through the album on shuffle, like to go from top to bottom, you know?
And I think queen.
Really listening to it in that order, I see why.
For sure.
You know, she wanted it to be heard that way.
And I think she makes a good point, right? Like any artist or any creator, when you create something, you create it with like an intention, like you want it to be consumed in a certain way. So to automatically make it through shuffle is, I don't know, I guess I've never thought about it because I'm not a musician, but it makes sense.
Do you think she's ever going to do an album that's like fun? Like, you know, you might have a club track in there. And I'm going to tell you, I mean, you know, I'm Jamaican. Jamaicans will find a way to make one of these tracks a club track, and that's fine. But like, do you think we're going to have like a upbeat like album?
No, for the main reason.
Why?
That Europeans love to do exactly what you just said. Yeah. Like they like to take a sad song and like put a beat to it, remix it, synthesize it. So I don't think she has to. I think she's
going
to
be do it. EDM people are going to do it. Reggae people are going to do it. Everybody's going to do it.
I've been to clubs in London where she's from, where you're listening to Rolling in the Deep and it's like people are amped. It's 2 o'clock in the morning. See? My God. That's exactly. And I'm sitting there in the club with my tea.
Yeah.
What?
Not the tea.
Sitting there in the club with my tea, thinking to myself, how did we get to a point where Rolling in the Deep is a bop?
You know what I want to know from you guys watching right now? Like, what is your favorite song on the album? Do you have a favorite song? Or do you have a top three like Dev? Like, let us know right now in the comments. And do you think this album was better than 25?
Yes.
Yeah?
Period. Hands down.
Because I've been reading mixed reviews that some people prefer 25.
So after we talked about this last time, I realized that I said my favorite song was Hometown Glory. But my favorite song of hers is actually... Some I Love to Your New, your new Lover, you know that one?
Your new
That one, yeah. Because
ooh, I didn't know you got some vocals in
I can sing. I will.
One day?
One day. I took vocal training for like 6 years.
Okay.
So I can sing. But I love her. And I love that song. See, that's kind of like a bop. Like that one's kind of fun.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, for sure.
Well, let us know. Do you prefer 25, do you prefer 30, or do you prefer 19?
What about 21?
21. Oh my gosh, I totally forgot about 21. Yeah, she has. I'm on that.
I was like, hold on a second. I missed a big one. Not 21.
21. Let us know in the comments. In the meantime, I think we got to kind of get back to work, eh?
But forever 21.
But forever 21? I don't know. I missed that. That's a good one. You want to know? It's because they went down here in Canada, so I don't even remember that they were a store. Hope your boy.
Help your voice.